Cefoperazone is a broad-spectrum cephalosporin antibiotic used for the treatment of bacterial infections in various locations, including the respiratory tract, abdomen, skin, and female genital tracts. In this video, let's find found. What is cefoperazone? What is cefoperazone used? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking cefoperazone? How does cefoperazone work? How to use cefoperazone? What is cefoperazone? Cefoperazone is a third-generation cephalosporin antibiotic, marketed by Pfizer under the name Cefobid. It is one of few cephalosporin antibiotics effective in treating Pseudomonas bacterial infections, which are otherwise resistant to these antibiotics. It was patented in 1974 and approved for medical use in 1981. What is cefoperazone used for? Indicated for the treatment of following infections caused by susceptible bacteria, label. 1. Respiratory tract infections caused by S. pneumoniae, H. influenza, S. aureus, penicillinase and non-penicillinase producing strains, S. pyogenes, group A beta hemolytic streptococci, P. aeruginosa, Klebsiella pneumoniae, E. coli, Proteus mirabilis, and Enterobacter species. 2. Peritonitis and other intra-abdominal infections caused by E. coli, P. aeruginosa, and anaerobic gram-negative bacilli, including Bacter fragilis. 3. Bacterial septicemia caused by S. pneumoniae, S. agalactiae, S. aureus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, E. coli, Klebsiella spp, Klebsiella pneumoniae, Proteus species, indole-positive and indole-negative. Clostridium spp. Aerobic gram-positive cocci. 4. Infections of the skin and skin structures caused by S. aureus, penicillinase and non-penicillinase producing strains, S. pyogenes, and P. aeruginosa. 5. Pelvic inflammatory disease, endometritis, and other infections of the female genital tract caused by N. gonorrhoeae, S. epidermitis, S. agalactiae, E. coli, Clostridium spp, Bacteroid species, including Bacteroides fragilis, and anaerobic gram-positive cocci. 6. Urinary tract infections caused by Escherichia coli and Pseudomonas aeruginosa. 7. Enterococcal infections. Although cefoperazone has been shown to be clinically effective in the treatment of infections caused by enterococci in cases of peritonitis and other intra-abdominal infections, infections of the skin and skin structures, pelvic inflammatory disease, endometritis, and infections of the female genital tract, and urinary tract infections. The majority of clinical isolates of enterococci tested are not susceptible to cefoperazone but fall just at or in the intermediate zone of susceptibility, and are moderately resistant to cefoperazone. However, in vitro susceptibility testing does not correlate directly with in vivo results. Despite this, cefoperazone therapy has resulted in clinical cures of enterococcal infections, chiefly in polymicrobial infections. Cefoperazone should be used in enterococcal infections with care and at doses that achieve satisfactory serum levels of cefoperazone. Contraindication. Contraindications: cefoperazone is contraindicated in conditions like hypersensitivity to any component of the product. Side effects. Cefoperazone contains an N-methylthiotetrazole, NMTT or 1-MTT, side chain. As the antibiotic is broken down in the body, it releases free NMTT, which can cause hypoprothrombinemia, likely due to inhibition of the enzyme vitamin K-epoxuctase, and a reaction with ethanol similar to that produced by disulfiram antabuse, due to inhibition of aldehyde dehydrogenase. Pharmacodynamic. Cefoperazone is a third-generation cephalosporin antibiotic. Cefoperazone exerts its bactericidal effect by inhibiting the bacterial cell wall synthesis. Mechanism of action. Like all beta-lactam antibiotics, cefoperazone binds to specific penicillin-binding proteins, PBPs, located inside the bacterial cell wall, causing the inhibition of the third and last stage of bacterial cell wall synthesis. Cell lysis is then mediated by bacterial cell wall autolytic enzymes such as autolysins. Half-life. The mean serum half-life is approximately 2.0 hours, independent of the route of administration. Dose. Usual adult dose for endometritis. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours to continue until 48 hours after clinical improvement has been observed. Appropriate oral antibiotic therapy may continue until 14 days of therapy has been completed. Usual adult dose for febrile neutropenia. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours. Therapy should be continued for 14 days, or until more specific therapy can be instituted for an identified pathogen, or until the patient has been afebrile for 24 hours after the absolute neutrophil count has reached at least 500 cells/mm3. Usual adult dose for intra-abdominal infection. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 7 to 14 days. Usual adult dose for joint infection. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 3 to 4 weeks. Longer therapy, 6 weeks or more, may be required with prosthetic joint infections. In addition, removal of the infected joint may be required. Usual adult dose for pelvic inflammatory disease. 1 to 2 g4 or IM 12 hours to continue until 48 hours after clinical improvement has been observed. Appropriate oral antibiotic therapy should then commence and continue until 14 days of therapy has been completed. Doxycycline therapy for 7 days, if not pregnant, or single dose azithromycin is also recommended to treat possible concurrent chlamydial infection. Usual adult dose for peritonitis. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 10 to 14 days. Usual adult dose for pneumonia. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 7 to 21 days, depending upon the causative organism. Usual adult dose for pyelonephritis. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 14 days. Usual adult dose for bacteremia. 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 14 days. Usual adult for skin or soft tissue infection. 1 to 2 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 7 days or for 3 days after inflammation subsides, depending on the nature and severity of infection. For more severe infections such as diabetic soft tissue infections, 14 to 21 days of therapy required. Usual adult dose for urinary tract infection. 1 g4 or IM every 12 hours for 3 to 7 days. Safety advice. Cefoperazone pregnancy warnings. Cefoperazone has been assigned to pregnancy category B by the FDA. Animal studies failed to reveal evidence of fetal harm. There are no controlled data in human pregnancy. Cefoperazone should only be given during pregnancy when need has been clearly established. That's all the information about cefoperazone we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.